Don't panic. That's ABC 10 health expert Dr. Pyle Coley's biggest message for Tuesday's pause on the Johnson & Johnson vaccine.
I think the CDC and FDA want to just take a time out, look at the data. And if I had to predict what they would do, I would likely say that because this is so rare, less than 1 in a million chance, and the vaccine is so effective, they're probably going to say certain groups are okay to go back and get that Johnson.
Coley says this pause is similar to Europe's pause earlier this year on the AstraZeneca vaccine, which is similar to the J&J. That vaccine was also linked to blood clots, but health officials determined it was safe and effective after days of review. Coley believes this review might take a few weeks.
A few weeks to really look at the data, make sure that they understand those six individuals, what their risk factors were.
If you got the vaccine within the past 3 weeks, Coley says keep your radar up.
Particularly if you're a young woman under the age of 50. And just keep your eyes open for anything that seems unusual.
The CDC says if you got the shot more than a month ago, your risk is low. If you're within those 3 weeks, like Coley said, and you have a severe headache, abdominal or leg pain, even shortness of breath, it's time to call your doctor.
Rest assured that even if, God forbid, you have this life-threatening complication, there are treatments that can be employed for it.
She says the pause should bring confidence in the vaccine, not fear.
But even though 6 out of over 6 million people had this really rare complication, less than the background rate, we're still pausing and taking a look. This is a natural part of what happens when millions of people get a vaccination. Some, because of genetic factors or other factors that we don't understand, may have reactions that most people don't have.